Hey everyone, and welcome to this week's weekly tips and tricks video. This week, I'm going to show you a quick trick on how to customize the loading screen for Maya to show an image different from what usually displays while Maya is preparing to open. Now, I know this trick isn't exactly groundbreaking for those of you hoping for a tip that would revolutionize your workflow once you're actually inside of Maya, but it's still a fairly cool little thing to do for those interested in, let's say, changing it up a bit or customizing the screen to match maybe whatever project you're working on. So let's go ahead and get started. So first, let's actually find the location of the existing loading screen and make a backup of it, just in case we want to revert to it at some point. So I'm just going to go on my C drive, go to Program Files, Autodesk, Maya, and then in the Icons folder, if you scrub down, you see there's an image here called Maya Startup Image. So I'm just going to go ahead and make a duplicate of this. Just do a copy paste right here. And then I'm just going to right-click and rename one of them as just underscore backup. Because we're going to eventually obviously be recreating and rewriting over this image right here. Actually, you know what? I put underscore backup on the actual original, so I'm just going to delete where it says copy here. So I'm just going to go ahead and open this now. Let's see, go to my computer, Program Files, Autodesk, Maya, Icons, and then just scroll down until I get there. So Maya startup image, here we are right here. So if we open the images, image size, we'll see that we got an 860 by 500 image. Now right here, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to unlock this layer. And I'm just going to control everything or hit control and select that layer and just delete it. And what I'm going to do from here is just kind of bring in a few quick images here to create a new image that I want for my Maya loading screen. So I'm going to go ahead and bring in the 3DM border and the custom loading screen JPEG that I had saved. I'm just going to hit Control A and Control C. I'm just going to kind of paste this into place. That should be good. And then same with the 3D border. Control V. As we'll see, that's pretty big. I'm going to go ahead and put this at the top corner here and then just kind of scale it down. So it snaps. Then I may move a few things around here. Okay, so let's say that this is the image that we want to work with now. If I just hit Control S, I'm just going to kind of rewrite over that file. Find my PNG down here. My startup image, just hit save. It's asking for when I overwrite it, just hit yes. Hit OK. And then if we go ahead and minimize Photoshop here, if I go ahead and load Maya, what we'll see is that the new loading screen is the loading screen that we just saved. So, again, like I said, this isn't some revolutionary workflow change, just kind of a neat little thing to do if you guys are interested in maybe customizing your loading screen for whatever project that you've got. It's just kind of a fun thing to know how to do. So all right, well that concludes this week's tips and tricks. Thanks again for watching 3dmotive.com.